Tensions between Azerbaijan and Armenia escalated again on Thursday when Armenia violated a ceasefire,
triggering the latest artillery bombardment and drone attacks north of Nagorno-Karabakh.
What's been described as the worst outbreak of violence.
Several homes in the Tovuz region were destroyed as the Armenian army hit a village with heavy artillery.
Tovuz region, it's strategically very important to Azerbaijan. Because this is the highland. Our battle position located on highland. And they wanted to capture that in order to keep under pressure all surrounding villages. And from that point, they can launch another attack in the depths of our defense in this region.
Why Armenia started from Tovuz? I believe they had a certain strategic goals, but they have failed to achieve them. Their first goal was to divert attention from the Armenia's occupation and aggression against Azerbaijan. In other words, from Nagorno-Karabakh problem. Secondly, they tried to pose strategic threats to the strategic communication links of Azerbaijan along the east-west corridor.
Ben Azerbaycan'ın Tovuz bölgesindenim. Bizim köye de bombalar düştü. Ve 30 küsür senedir ki benim köyüm ateş altında. Ermenilerle sınırlı olmam sebebinden. Şimdiye kadar köyümüzden 30 mülkü vatandaş öldü. Yani öğretmenler, köylüler. Evinde otururken evine bomba düştü. Şehit oldu saldırılarda.
From the first moment of this incident that happened in Tovuz region, starting from 12th of July, we immediately felt the great support from Turkey.
Bizi ilk destekleyen ve bir manalı şekilde destekleyen ülke Türkiye olmuştur. Aziz kardeşim, hürmetli Cumhurbaşkanı Recep Tayyip Erdoğan, bir neçe defa çok keskin ve ciddi açıklamalar vermiştir.
Türkiye, kadim dostluk bağları ve kardeşlik ilişkilerinin bulunduğu Azerbaycan'ın hakkına, hukukuna, topraklarına yönelik her türlü saldırının karşısında yer almakta asla tereddüt göstermeyecek.
Önce Erdoğan'ın Cumhurbaşkanı çıkışı oldu. Çok sert Ermeniler açısından ve net bir çıkıştı. Onun ardınca ise ordunun Azerbaycan'a gelişi, Türk şahinlerinin Azerbaycan semalarında kalmıştı. Ciddi, önemli bir gelişmedi. Yani bu tatbikatlar öyle bir kritik zamana denk geldi ki bu Azerbaycan halkının hususen de bölgede...
I will say that military exercises and joint military action between Turkey and Azerbaijan has its emotional, symbolic and practical part. In 1918, Turkish soldiers came to Azerbaijan to support their brothers. It was a difficult time for the Turkey. It wasn't a First World War, but they came as a brotherly support, so that to stop the bloodshed of Azerbaijanis that have been conducted by Armenians and Dashnak groups and also Bolsheviks.
1918 yılında Nuri Paşa'nın askeri ordusu, Kafkas İslam ordusu Azerbaycan'a geldi. O zaman da Rus ve Ermeni birlikleri Bakı'da katliam yapmışlardı. 30 bin Azerbaycan Türk'ünü katletmişlerdi. Onlar geldi kurtardı. Nuri Paşa'nın ordusu 1100 şehit verdi.
100 later, in 2018, with the presence of the leaders of two countries, President Ilham Aliyev and President Recep Erdoğan, and Azerbaijani armed forces and Turkish armed forces marched through the downtown of Baku, center of Baku.
Türkiye ve Azerbaycan geçmişi bir, kültürü bir, dili bir, dini bir, iki kardeş ülkedir. Bizler büyük şair merhum Bahtiyar Vahapzade'nin o güzel ifadesiyle bir ananın iki oğlu, bir amalın iki kolu. O da ulu, bu da ulu. Azerbaycan, Türkiye.
Türkiye, Azerbaycan halkına daim inkişaf, terakki arzulamak istəyirəm və bildirmək istəyirəm ki, Türkiyə-Azərbaycan dostluğu sarsılmazdır, əbədidir.
Turkish-Azerbaijani cooperation, partnership and brotherhood. It first of all comes from the ethnic kinship between the two countries, and based on this ethnic kinship, and our countries are building with a strategic and comprehensive cooperation in all spheres. First of all, this cooperation is a mutually beneficial cooperation for the benefit of Azerbaijani people and for the benefit of the Turkish people. By this cooperation, Azerbaijan and Turkey extensively contribute to the regional peace, regional prosperity and regional development. One example, TANAP and TAP project. It brings together Caspian Sea, South Caucasus, Black Sea region, Georgia, Balkan countries, European countries, and finally contributes to the energy security of the European Union. And it also consists of oil and gas pipeline systems, including the East-West or Silk Way road connectivity, which is also a road that connects Central Asia, Caspian Sea with the Black Sea and Mediterranean Sea. In Azerbaijan and Turkey, we believe that best prosperity is a shared prosperity. These are all elements that contribute to the regional peace, security and architecture. Here's a question. Can Armenia be part of that, of this process? The answer is yes, but Armenia must end as a policy of occupation. It should finally build civil relations with the neighbors and also with Azerbaijan and with Turkey.
Yukarı Karabağ'ın işgalinden beri bu bölgede süren gerginliğin Ermenistan'ın pervasız ve sistematik saldırıları sebebiyle çatışmaya dönüşmesinden dolayı endişeliyiz.
Türkiye'nin, Azerbaycan'ın bütün platformlarda, tek Karabağ konusunda değil, bütün konularda Azerbaycan'ın yanında olduğunu her birimiz biliyoruz. Ona göre de hem de mutluyuz. Ve yalnız 10 milyon olmadığımızı anlatan bir geçer.
We are one nation and two states. It's a very emotional thing for every Azerbaijani, and I believe it's also a very emotional thing for every citizen of Turkey. Based on the slogan, and we have a very prospective future, and we are moving towards that direction.